All right, hi, this is Ask Dr. Ben. I'm Dr. Ben Newman. I study coronaviruses, particularly molecular biology. That's the area where I at least got some knowledge. Yeah. So let's answer your questions. The next question is from Diego. Yeah, hello again, Diego. All right, so as the race for the COVID-19 vaccine continues, there are also many other therapeutics that are being developed to fight the virus. This is true, yes. I was wondering about your thoughts on this one, which is a nasal spray that blocks the absorption of SARS coronavirus 2, tested on ferrets by a team. So this is a thing that you could squirt up, well, a ferret's nose or your nose probably, that would work. And it's, look through the paper, it's actually a very neat drug. It's built on pretty solid science. Overall, I don't know that it's going to have the kind of effect on humans that we would be looking for. Ferret nostrils are kind of little compared to ours. Ferrets don't have little fingers that they put up their nostrils. There's, you know, all kinds of reasons why, it may work a little differently. I'm not sure how much sort of mucus flow you would normally get in ferret nostrils, although I know they are a pretty good model for influenza and for SARS-CoV-2. So yeah, that's at least something there. They're not a bad choice at all. And we probably still have a lot to learn there. So all right, what is this compound? Well, it's it is a little part of the spike protein. And so they take a little protein from the bottom of it. And so the way the spike actually gets into your cells, so it has a little bit that will stick to the cell, and that's fine. And then what it's going to do is it's going to kind of unfold like a transformer. So it's got a little part that's like a hook, just like that, and it's curled up on the inside. And then once it gets close enough to the membrane or even inside the cell, it's going to open out and it hooks into the membrane. So it's kind of grabbing on. And then these two parts here are actually going to fold together, and that kind of crashes the virus down into the cell. And so what they're doing with this peptide, this little piece of a protein, is they are mimicking one of the two parts. They're actually mimicking the bottom part on this that should snap together and bring the virus kind of crashing down onto the cell. And this is something that's been tried before and works pretty well, at least in cell culture. If you put in a direct copy of one half of this little machine that should be snapping together, then the copy of your drug will snap down onto the other half instead of it snapping itself. And when that happens, the virus is stuck. It's tethered to the cell, it's kind of hooked into the cell, but it can't actually get in. Eventually it breaks down, falls apart, you get no virus entry. Really smart. The other very smart thing that they did with this particular drug is that instead of just having single loose little proteins floating around, which is, I've worked with some of these before, and they work okay in cell culture. They have actually attached the protein to a cholesterol molecule. And there's a ton of cholesterol. The virus actually needs cholesterol to be at the site that it's trying to enter. And so by targeting the drug with cholesterol, it's going to end up in the right part of the membrane where the cholesterol tends to localize. And so, yeah, it's in the right place now to do the job. That probably makes it a little bit more efficient than just the regular protein on its own. I think they actually show that some of their graphs. And then the other super smart thing that they did was they actually hooked together so that they have not just one of these little proteins, but multiple proteins. Because remember, spikes come in threes. There are three copies of the same protein that make up a spike, and each one of those is doing this hooking and reeling in, just like fishing, basically. That's how the spike works. And so you have a chance to block two of those at the same time, two out of three. And two out of three is a majority, and so that spike is not going to work, and it's not going to be able to cause fusion, which means the virus is not going to be able to enter the cell. It's just going to get stuck on the outside. And so, yeah, the cholesterol, the sort of twin little peptides, these are nice little things that I hadn't seen anywhere before. Perhaps I'm just not reading all the right papers, but this looks new. And I am not surprised that it worked as well as it did. As for will it work in people, I think it could work and it could help a little bit, but I don't think this is going to be a solution that means that we don't have to wear masks, because there are surfaces other than the nose where if the virus gets in there, you're going to become infected. So if the virus makes it past and doesn't try to land in the nose, makes it down into your lungs as you breathe in through nose or mouth, then yeah, all this stuff that you did up there in your nose is neat, but it's going to prevent a nose infection. It's not going to prevent an infection. Ferrets are also probably mostly being infected through the nose, whereas I think with humans it can be through the nose and mouth. We talk a lot more than ferrets do, for one thing. Yeah. I haven't been around enough ferrets to know that for sure. But I don't know that it will be practically effective, but it's really good science, and I think deployed in the right way, it's going to at least help a little bit. It's good, smart science. And I recognize some of the names involved in the science. And these are people that know what they're doing, that have worked on coronaviruses for a long time. And it shows. Yeah, it shows. So there we go. Thanks very much. Very good question. Very interesting little antiviral tool. Yeah. And this has been Ask Dr. Ben.